The Rookery Bay Environmental Learning Center near Marco Island is a great place to learn about some of the curious creatures that live in the Gulf waters. Like this one, volunteer educator Mr. Richard Genevin showed us.
This is a giant red hermit crab, and this is like one of a dozen different species of crabs we have in Florida here. And this is their pincers out here. Why do you think it lives inside of a shell? This is not part of their body.
Because it might be soft inside, because it'd be easier for predators to eat them.
That's true, that's very true. Everything gets eaten, and so this one doesn't want to be eaten, so what it does is it adopts this shell. Most of them live in the sea. There's one species in the Florida Keys that lives on land.
How do they live on land?
They don't have lungs like we do, they have gills. And the ones that live on the land, they run to the water and they wet their gills, and then they're able to breathe air through their gills. As long as their gills are wet, they can breathe. And here we have a spider crab. Wow. And you can see how long their legs are on here. That's why they call them a spider crab. And they're pretty lazy once they become an adult. They just kind of roam around picking up food debris that's left over from other animals. They've got three sets of mouth parts for their mouth.
Why do they have three sets of mouth parts?
Well, because they have to break things apart and they have to feed things into their mouth. And so they use their mouth parts to do that. Instead of having heavy teeth like we do, they've got these mouth parts.
Did you know that spider crabs like to dress up? If they see something pretty, they'll pick it up and stick it on their back. Okay, this is a weird fish. It doesn't even look like it's alive. Education specialist David Graff knows a lot about the curious creatures in the Gulf.
This one is called a barbfish or a scorpionfish.
Why is it called a scorpionfish?
Well, it's called a scorpionfish because what do scorpions do?
They sting.
They sting, okay. What this fish does is, do you see its back? On the back, it has a fin, and those fins have got a lot of sharp little barbs in them. And if you were to step on it or put your hand on top of it, those fins can actually inject a venom into your hand or foot, and it doesn't feel very good. It's an ambush predator, and it just sits. Can you see its gills moving?
No.
It just sits and waits for a little crab or a little shrimp or a little fish that's not paying attention to slowly walk towards it. And, oh, there he goes. This fish has an enormous mouth, and it will just swallow its prey whole.
Hi.
This is the striped burfish, and see how he's got all those spines sticking off his back right now?
Yeah.
He's not scared, and because he's not scared, there's skin that covers those spines, but when this animal is scared, if it gets threatened by a predator, it swallows a bunch of water or a bunch of air, and it stretches its body out, and the skin gets stretched out on its back, and those spines are sticking out, and they're really, really sharp.
He's got a mouth that's actually more like a parrot's beak.
And what are parrot's beaks good for?
For chewing things.
Do they chew?
No, they like crack things.
They crack things, right. So what might a fish want to crack? With
shell.
Really strong, exactly, shells of clams and also shells of crabs and things like that.
Oysters.
Yep, so that's what these guys like to eat.
It was this fish's lucky day, because we got to feed him some shrimp. Have you ever swallowed a mouthful of water when swimming in the ocean? Mr. Dave put a drop of seawater under a microscope for us, and what we saw was very cool. Meet phytoplankton.
Phytoplankton is plant plankton. Zooplankton is animal plankton, and that's what we're going to be seeing in our microscopes. So if you want to go ahead and push that button number one and look through your microscope.
Oh, look, there's tons of them.
The word plankton means drifter. So plankton is stuff that gets pushed around by the winds and by the currents. The phytoplankton produces more oxygen for all of us on the planet than all of the plants on the ground. That's pretty amazing. So phytoplankton is really important.
See those plankton moving really fast? They're baby barnacles. Earlier in the day, education coordinator Miss Sarah told us about the important role barnacles and oysters play in keeping the water clean.
So take a look at the bottom of this dock. It's full of encrusting organisms called barnacles. And these barnacles are tiny little shelled animals that are filter feeders. They make the water clean.
Why are they called encrusting animals?
Well, they live on docks and pilings and boats and things that are underwater. They have to live on something hard to be able to survive. They actually filter the water by eating plankton. They take their foot out sweep through the water like a giant feather, and the particles in the water that they're collecting are plankton.
Do oysters also filter the water?
They do. Oysters are really important for water quality. One oyster in our area is able to filter about 2 gallons of water in 1 hour.
Wow.
Miss Sarah showed us how the research team at Rookery Bay Reserve test the water to see how cloudy it is or how salty. This data helps them monitor the effects of freshwater entering the estuaries in the wrong amounts at the wrong times. These things matter to all the plants and animals that live there.